the GME Innovations Fund was instrumental for our research, which focuses on teaching and learning in the operating room, and some really exciting stuff that we've been able to develop out of that focuses on entrustment in the operating room. And for many generations, individuals have focused on just the resident or just the learner. And what we've really focused on is the interaction between faculty and residents and the trust that's established between those two groups. And the most important part of this project I want to tell you about is the team that helped bring this idea to fruition. So Scott Page talks about the diversity bonus, and our team included medical students, residents, education scientists, surgeons, statisticians, so a breadth of individuals with a breadth of cognitive diversity. And I think because of all of those different perceptions and perspectives, we were really able to be innovative and push each other and think about research in the operating room in some really unique ways. One of the most important outcomes that has come from this work is our faculty development and resident development process. And really what anchors that is an instrument called OpTrust. And OpTrust is based on five different domains of third-party or objective observable behaviors. And this is a very unique way of assessing that interaction in the operating room. Often we rely on residents or faculty members' perceptions about how they think the interaction went or how the learner is progressing. And what this does is give some really valuable third-party feedback to both the faculty member and the resident about trust in the operating room, about autonomy, about their behaviors, and how they can then enhance those to optimize that teaching and learning relationship. So other specialties have become very interested in this. So urology, obstetrics and gynecology, genetic counseling. So there are diverse specialties who also see benefit in taking the principles from OpTrust and adapting them for their own educational environments. This work is first of its kind in the field, where we've started to look at the relationship between education and outcomes. And there has been a call for this from many different scholars, that we really need to look at education in relationship to patient outcomes, in relationship to resident outcomes. And this work has been able to move in that direction. And so we're really excited about sort of the next phase of our research, which has also been funded by the GME Innovations Grant. And what we're looking at is patient outcomes before and after implementation of the OpTrust intervention. And so we're really excited to see where that work might go. So it's been exciting to see more institutions around the country really embrace this idea. Institutions across the United States, such as the University of Wisconsin, where my co-collaborator Rebecca Minter is the chair in the Department of Surgery, all the way to the West Coast at OHSU, to the South at the University of Alabama, and also in Rochester in New York. And several other institutions have adopted OpTrust and are engaging in this faculty and resident development. And if there are other institutions that are interested in collaborating or would like to have more information, they can visit our site, Education Research Sciences Collaborative, or they can feel free to reach out to me directly.